Hi, I'm Scott. This is a question that comes up on the Facebook forums, particularly for the Emodex. I have Emodex right here, but it applies to all synthesizers of all types, and it's specifically when you have a synthesizer connected to an audio interface and also connected to your computer, which you're using as your digital audio workstation or DAW. And the problem is that you're getting digital noise on the audio path. So you're working on your computer, moving windows around on your computer and your DAW, and you're doing work as you're recording, and then you hear in the audio path coming from your synthesizer, you hear this digital noise, and it sounds, this I actually captured it, and this is what it sounds like coming out of my Roland System 8. So this is the type of noise that you would hear that's actually caused by this specific problem. I'm going to show you how it's caused, where it comes from, and more importantly, how to get rid of it. Here we have a simple diagram of a typical system. We've got our synthesizer, audio interface, our monitors, and our DAW computer. We have an audio connection that goes from the synthesizer to the audio interface. We have another audio connection from the audio interface going to the monitors. We have a USB connection going from the computer to the audio interface, and a USB from the synth to the computer. Now, we don't have just one wire. The USB wire has a ground, and the audio has a ground as well. In actuality, the USB has two wires, a plus and minus digital wire plus a ground, which is our differential. But the signals are not referenced to ground. Now, we have audio going from the synthesizer to the audio interface so that we can record it. We have audio from the interface to the monitor so that we can hear what we're working on. Bidirectional USB going back and forth between the audio interface to the computer so that we can record and play back digitized audio. And we have bidirectional USB between the synth and the computer so that we can record and play back MIDI data. The audio signal is referenced to ground. The signal of the audio is the difference between the signal wire and the ground wire. That's unbalanced audio. Now, we may have balanced audio, which is not referenced to ground. In that case, the signal is the difference between the two wires. In this case, we're talking about unbalanced audio. Now, here's the problem. We have one ground that comes from the USB wire from the synth to the computer. We have another ground from the USB wire from the computer to the audio interface. And one ground that is part of the audio signal from the synth to the audio interface. In a perfect world, all these grounds would be connected together and would be exactly the same. The problem is, grounds aren't exactly the same due to cable loss or circuit design on the motherboard and the computer, poor filtering, or any of another host of reasons. In a perfect world, all these grounds would be exactly the same, 0 volts. But in the real world, the ground between the computer and the audio interface has digital noise on it from the computer, so a tiny bit of voltage is not perfectly zero. The audio interface ties all these grounds together, so the digital noise gets referenced to the audio signal ground, which induces noise onto the audio signal. So all that digital noise on the ground from the computer is now part of your audio signal. So how do we fix this? You can break the ground on the audio chain from the synthesizer to the audio interface with a ground loop isolator. This is a transformer. It transforms the electrical signal into magnetism, and then from magnetism back to an electrical signal, without there actually being a physical connection between the two. This could be called a ground loop isolator or a DI box. But basically, all it is just a transformer. The problem is, it colors the sound. Anytime you transform the sound from electrical to magnetic and back to electrical, you actually alter the quality of that sound. You may lose some of the top end, you may lose some of the bottom end. Also, if there's anything else in the vicinity, could be power wires, power supplies, anything at all that creates a magnetic field can induce noise into the transformer, so you may end up with more noise than you started with. The best way to do it is using a USB ground loop isolator. This is something that disconnects the ground, but passes the digital signal through. So this is what I use. It's the iFi iDefender. It's a USB ground loop interrupter. It passes through the digital signal without passing through the ground. So it basically is there's no electrical connection between the input and the output of this device. It transfers the data through, but no actual physical electrical signal, and thereby breaking the ground loop that causes the digital noise. This is a type A to type A connector. You can get them type A, type C, type C, type C, what have you. If the device requires power, USB power, in order to function, for instance, you may have a synthesizer that has, it uses USB power, and it doesn't have any other source of power. Maybe a small synthesizer of some sort. You can actually plug in a USB power supply into the side of this to supply power, because there's no electrical connection between the input and output. Your computer can't power the device. So in that case, you would have to supply extra power by plugging it in the side there. But I have many of these. I think I've probably got 5 or 6 of these in all my different synths, and it fixes the problem every single time. Highly recommended. I put a link, Amazon link down below, where you can actually buy these. Hopefully this is some help to you. Hopefully this will answer the question that keeps getting posted on the Facebook forums about getting rid of this type of digital noise over and over and over again. If you have any comments or questions, please add them below. And if you like this video, think it's useful, click like. Thanks.